I woke up on a Friday morning, I was out of town, my husband and I were in Charleston, and I was, you know, washing my face, putting on my moisturizer, and I just felt two lumps right here. I was just numb, I suppose is the best way to think of it. You just don't, just didn't think too much. It was just, okay, something's not right, and but I'm just not gonna think too much until we know more. It was Dr. Kelly that called Rob's cell phone personally, and he just said, I just got your wife's numbers, and I need to see her tonight. I don't want you to wait until tomorrow. I got to the hospital, was admitted, and they started pushing IV fluids right away, and by the next morning my white count was down to 40,000. Did a bone marrow biopsy that morning, and then had diagnosis by Tuesday afternoon of acute lymphoblastic leukemia.
She had a very high risk acute leukemia. She had some very adverse prognostic factors, including the Philadelphia chromosome, which puts her at a very high risk for disease recurrence. And so the way that we tend to approach that disease, and everybody's a little different, but that disease with her at her age range, we would look at a donor type of transplant to use the chemotherapy and the immune system effects of the new stem cell or new immune system.
Before this, we always thought that we were in control of things, right? Like we can decide to do this, we can decide to do this, but then you get presented with something like cancer and you realize how helpless you are in so many ways. So that was the one thing that he felt like he could still control, was where we chose to go for treatment. You know, he looked into going to MD Anderson and, you know, is that where we should be going? Should we be going, you know, to University of Minnesota? Should we be going somewhere other than here? But just in his conversations with Kelly, he just was just certain that this was where we were supposed to be.
Really, any FDA-approved type of pathways of therapy or care, we can deliver here, and we do so with patients that are closer to home. They don't have to travel. They keep their support network, and we do it in a fashion that is hopefully comforting for them and allows them to have hope that they can get through this. We have taken a very holistic approach to patient care. So we have a tiered type, a layered system of physicians, obviously, because we need someone to do some of this, but nurses, social workers, patient advocates, even our front-end reception staff are excellent, and they become friends with patients.
They're my family. I mean, they get to know not only your sickness and your health, but they get to know all of you.
It is personable care. It's close to home. It's as good a care as what anybody will receive anywhere. There's no technological advances that we can't necessarily give here that someone else can do.
I just couldn't imagine doing treatment anywhere else.